Hi everyone, this is Arshan and welcome back to my channel. For today, we'll be having Tazenzani Land of One version from One Piece. Let's go! I'm gonna talk about all the very small details that I did painted on this kit. Well, it's very challenging as you can see because it's really small and this is my first time doing such an effort for a plastic model kit. But obviously I did enjoy this, but it's really hard. So yeah, you can watch how I struggle. And by the way, every paint that I did use for this kit are all Tamiya brands, and all of them are acrylic paints. So I did bought a lot of acrylic paints for this one because, you know, I would like it to look anime accurate as much as possible. So I hope I did manage to do that. So comment down below, what do you think of this custom build? So for this part, I did use Tamiya Panel Line Accent Color Brown in order to give it a wash. Obviously, you can do this with a brown paint with water, but I did choose to use the panel line to, you know, enhance the details. Now, this is the part wherein my creativity kicked in because just like what I said earlier that I want this to be anime accurate. So for those anime fans of One Piece, we obviously know that they have a long grass in the middle of Tazenzani, and that's what I'm aiming here, obviously. So I did cut some papers and trace it on a fake grass paper. The size is A3. Also, I did use a fake grass powder for this one in order to give the the fake grass look. And I did pasted it by using water with glue. So yeah. And now for the mini swing. They have a swing in Thousand Sunny, and here I have a small plastic which is a rectangular loop that I did cut off from this plastic tree. So it doesn't look a swing to me, so I did cut it, remove it, then I tried improvising to do a mini swing. So I think I did manage to make it work. It looks cute. Moving on to the minifigures of this kit. Before I did painted this minifigures, I did think twice or thrice before doing so because they're very small and I want to put all the details on it, but you know, it's very small, but I did push it because I love One Piece. Yeah. Now for the construction of the Thousand Sunny, putting all the parts that I did custom painted for this kit, seeing all the small details painted on is very very satisfying for me because there are some small windows, small doors, there's some metal parts that's very small as well. You know, very very small details, but I did pull it off. I did manage to paint them. And I did have some hesitation at first because it's very detailed and I have that urge to make it anime accurate. That's why I have this hesitation with me. But at the end of the day, I did enjoy building this kit. I did enjoy putting all that effort because I know it really did pay off. And yeah, I love this kit. So if you have any suggestions, please do comment down below and like this video, share this to your friends, and please do consider subscribing to my channel. Thank you. Introducing the Straw Hat Pirates. So for manga readers and anime watchers of One Piece, obviously the arc is now in Wano, and their costumes are very detailed. There's so much design on it, but I did try my best to make them look as much as close to the design itself, and be my judge if I did do it right or it's a meh. But all in all, I am satisfied with the work that I did here, and seeing them all together makes my effort very very rewarding. So yeah, once again, here are the Straw Hat Pirates wearing their Land of Wano costume.